So okay guys, I'm on Facebook right now. I can download the pictures either from Facebook or from Google, as I showed you on laptop again. But sometimes I like downloading from Facebook. I prefer Facebook sometimes because when you come to Facebook, you see another side of the story entirely again. Another kind of narrative concerning that particular story, you get. So it gives you more idea. It makes it look a little bit more interesting, you get. And so this is picture. I just tap on it. I tap on it again. These three pictures appear and I save to phone. So after you downloaded that picture, I repeat the same thing for this one. I save to phone. Now we need to look for the picture of the girl in question who accused the bunch of raping her. So let's pray we would to get her. This one's most likely our links from Punch. If I tap them, to be taking me to Punch website, and I don't want that. So let's try this. I don't know if okay. No, this is not the girl. This is Mochida. This is another girl. I think she's not in Nigeria, but she's a celeb in one of these African countries that was remarking to the rape allegation. So yes, this is the girl. So if you are not sure of the faces of these particular people, you can actually just go to Google. The one that comes out the most repeatedly, you're able to know easily the particular person's face. Oh, it's taking me out of Facebook. That particular is taking me out of Facebook. And I don't want to leave Facebook. So let me just scroll down. So I can download this video, for instance, and add it to this particular video and upload it. So this was one video he did recently, and it went viral. So this is the most commonest picture of this particular girl that you've come across. Now on Facebook, you can see all here, posts, people, events, group. I can look and switch to photos, just the way I did on Google. I can switch to photos and it will give me just a result of pictures of the bunch or the bunch related stories and stuff like that. I'm not at home with the result. I'm not impressed. And that thing I could do is add rape to it, so that it will know exactly the kind of the bond pictures I'm looking for. So to bring out those pictures that are having those keywords, or pictures that were uploaded with that kind of storyline. So let me add the band rip. So finally, I think I got her. Save to phone. Here's another screenshot. So right now, I'm satisfied with the number of pictures that I've gotten. I can now go to my software, that's KineMaster. So KineMaster has opened. These are some of my previous videos. So what I usually like doing is from KineMaster here, there's this settings button by the left hand side. You see, it has J icon around it. I'll just tap on it. Take note, this is the settings area. You don't have to do this all the time. Because I'm teaching you, that's why I'm showing you. Here, you can set your default settings. How many seconds do you want the video to slide? Mine, I left it on the default settings for 6 seconds. Then, what kind of animation do you want it to carry when the pictures are sliding? You know, you can leave it to any of those. So I left it at Ken Burns. You know, so you can play around with the settings. Those are just the things you need to look out for. You can actually record your audio directly inside the software. You get, so you also have options for audio settings and all that. So what I will just do is you can tap on this plus here, but I usually do not use it. You know, this big plus, the biggest icon here by your left hand side. So, but by below it, you see question mark. By the right hand side of the question mark, there is a I don't know, is it like a magic wand icon that is there? So I like using that one. I just tap on it. It asked me to put the title. Look at this, it's title, and I can title it the branch. This one doesn't mean anything, you can title anything. I tattoo the band drip and I click OK. So it's asking me to pick my picture. So it will open the media gallery of your device. You see your videos, your pictures. So anything you want to add, either you can mix both videos and pictures. You get. So right now it's going to categorize them. You can see after it, by your left hand side, if we start from the very first option, you see background, favorite, cloud. The next one is Facebook, AZ recorder free, screen recorder, video, UC browser, camera, download, DJ splat, just like that. Now we're after Facebook, so we'll tap on Facebook. Look at the pictures we just downloaded just now. So I'll just tap on the picture. As I'm tapping, if you look at the bottom, you see that the pictures are not appearing. They're coming up at the bottom. So I will keep tapping them repeatedly. This particular video is about 2 minutes, you know, so don't tap it too much. If you just tap it for the first time, it's okay. You can just click on next. You can add more pictures later on, so you can just tap on next. Here it's asking you for theme. What kind of theme do you want to use? There are different kind of themes here. I like using this last one called basic. I just tap on it because it doesn't ask me funny questions, doesn't have effects to read. I like it plain. If you want to add effect, you can use this other one. You have on stage, yeah, you have serene, you have travel, you have other ones you can download online. So when I like the basic, I just tap on basic. So when I tap on basic, it's highlighted. There's a red highlight around it. I go to next. It's asked me to put a write-up. At the beginning of the video, you can put a write-up. At the ending of the video, another write-up will appear in the middle, another write-up will be there. I don't put anything there, I just skip it and go to next. From here, it's asking me to put the audio. Take note, most of the time when you create an audio file, it will name it with some funny name. So I usually rename my audio files to something I can recognize. I renamed this one as the band. So I'll just scroll down. Look at it, I've seen it. So it arranges your write-up in alphabetical order. So and you can see by the extreme left-hand side, you see it has categorized them. There are some other music assets, some other SFX assets, some other recorded, some other songs. So I'm on that songs right now. You can see it has this reddish color highlight. The another, if you have album. So if there's a particular location that your audio is, you can scroll through it and get it from there. So I'll just tap on the band drip. If you look at the screen very well, you'll be seeing the band drip. That's the audio I created. It's 2 minutes 19 seconds. Look at, by your extreme right hand side, the number of minutes of each audio is there. If you know the minutes, it will help you a lot, you know, so that you don't over add the pictures and slides. So I just tap on the band drip and I go to, then as I tap on the band drip, you see it starts talking, but the audio has not still added to the, it has not been added to the to your slideshow yet. You see, when I tapped on that debug, it turned to red and there's a plus button that appeared. by your right hand side beside the play button. I just tapped it just now to pause the voice. So you tap on that plus. That plus means add it to what? My slideshow. And as I tapped on the plus, at the top, the boundary appeared again. At the extreme top, you see an X beside it. That is to say I can remove it. I can add more audio to it. But the boundary is okay. Once you tap the plus one, don't tap it twice. I go to next. So you see, my slideshow is already ready. By my extreme right, the play button is there, just above my timeline. Once I play it, can you see it?
My name is International Kelimero.
Can you see it?
Advisor to the governor.
Can you see it?
Marriage and private enjoyment, life nonsense. Don't forget to subscribe to this.
It has added effect for me. It has added effect for me. Everything. Now I want to go to the ending of this particular video. I'll just scroll. I'll tap on this timeline where these little picture icons are appearing at the bottom. Just from your right hand side, tap on your phone. Oops. Just tap on your phone and scroll towards the left, from right to left. So right now, below this picture icons of the band under the timeline area, you see some audio wavelength, but it's not very very visible, like it's faint, like black and white, ash color or grayscale. I will tap on it. Once I tap on it, you see that red highlight is now around it. And then there are new options that came up by the right hand side. Among the ones that came up by the right hand side, I'm interested in extend to end of project. My right hand side, are you seeing it? It's on. I will tap it to off it. Once I tap it to off it, my audio becomes longer than the slideshow. All these areas now, there's no picture in them. They are blank. Until I reach the actual end of this, the actual end of the video now. Around 2 minutes, look at the time. You know, there's this red marker on my screen right now, red indicator that's also showing the time. As I'm moving through the timeline, you see the time is moving. It's on 1 minute 59 seconds. If I move it again, 1 minute 48 seconds, just like that. So I will come and put this my cursor at the point where the last picture is. Where the last picture is, then I'll click outside of the audio layer. From there, by my right hand side, King Master's tools are arranged. You can see media at the top. By the right hand side, you have audio. Beneath, you have voice. Now I was telling you just now that you can record your voice right here. By the left hand side, you have layer. I'll just tap on media. It will bring out all my pictures, my videos in my phone again. I'll just still go to the same Facebook and I keep tapping on the band pictures repeatedly, one after the other, until I get to the end. I've gotten to the end of the audio clip now. In fact, I went above the audio clip. I had to add the band picture again in front. So I'll tap on the picture. You see, it's now selected. It's having a yellow highlight this time. And then by your left hand side, can you see a trash can button? I can use it to delete. By your left in the middle, there's a trash can button there. Once I tap it, that particular picture will be deleted. I can use this pattern to delete my audio, delete my video, restart, and what have you. So I am done with my video. Is that not easy? This is easy. If you want to do this with Photoshop, 2 hours, I mean with Premiere Pro, with the standard editing software, 2 hours, you are still on this video, we are still on 2 minutes animating it. So this thing adds the nice effect for raw slideshow and everything. So the next thing I want to do is just tap on to save it. By my right hand side, at the top, there is an icon at the top. Extreme top is the highest icon at the top, just before you have the time and the date and the percentage of my phone. You get. So all I just need to do is I tap on that button. Can you see the band drip has been added to my list of videos, and it's the one at the top, the band drip. You'll be looking at your right hand side. Well, not the extreme right. Oh, the extreme right has Oshumole's picture. That is an old video, about 7 minutes video. So we can see the band drip. If you have been following this video carefully, you know that all our projects so far, we have been naming it the same consistent name, the band drip, so that it will be easy for you to follow up this video. Now this is the band drip. I will tap on it once. Once I tap on it once, it opens up, and then towards the right hand side, after you have the normal title of the band drip, beneath it you have the date it was created and the length of the video. Beneath it you have now have the play button, you have the share button, you have another three dot option, and then you have the trash can button. Now I'm after the second one, that is the share button. You see it's having three leg, you know, like share. If you are familiar with Android phones, that's the icon for share. So I will tap on it. Once I tap on it, it takes me to the export page. This time it's going to export the video for me into MP4. And there are the video, we have different quality of videos. You get. Now I can increase the quality of my video. You know, but if I increase the quality of my video, the size of the video will increase too. So I usually like leaving it in low. You know, that's the interesting thing about this particular kind of video. Your audience, they do not care about quality of the video. They don't just care, because they are not after the visuals. It's that voice they want to hear. So even if the video is not so clear, they don't really mind. You get. Then at the under resolution frame, we just leave everything the way it is. Although you can put it in full HD. It's presently on HD 720 pixel. You know, I just switched it to 180 pixel. That is full HD. So, but I don't want full HD to increase the file size. You know, and I don't want to finish the memory of my phone. So I will leave it as HD. Just leave it everything. You don't need to change anything. I only moved some of the options so that you see that you can adjust options here. Then you just tap on export. Now I'm exporting. It's usually very, very fast. Although I'm using Samsung Galaxy, I don't know if that's the reason, but even laptop is not this fast. If I start rendering of this video, this 2 minutes video on laptop and on this phone will finish rendering before the laptop. So that is how fast, efficient, quick, and easy it is. See, the video almost finished rendering. Usually, if you give this particular video to a laptop, it can take it up to 15 minutes to render, or 10 minutes. But in less than 1 minute, our video has finished rendering. Look at it, has finished rendering. Once it's finished rendering, it will bring you back to this page. So don't be confused. Sometimes it can be so fast, you think it has not rendered. You go and tap export again, though. It has finished rendering. If you go to your gallery now, you see it there. Your normal video gallery, you see it there. So let's go to our video gallery. Okay, our video gallery. See, my phone is already showing a lot that there's no space again. So if I go to videos, look at export, the last option there, export 82 MB.
My name is International Kelly Mary, this is no special advisor to the governor on illegal marriage and private enjoyment life nonsense. Don't forget.
So guys, my video is ready for upload. I'll go to YouTube now. Look at YouTube here. I'll be sure that on my phone is that particular Gmail. I have so many Gmails on my phone right now. So, but I will just make sure that is that particular Gmail that is linked to my phone. You get. So I will just tap on YouTube. It's not saying my Wi-Fi has gone off. I'm not seeing network again. So I will just showing no connection. I just tap on this plus button at the top. There's a camera icon at the top of this YouTube. After you have where they wrote YouTube, say camera button before the search icon, before the profile picture icon, I tap on it. Once I tap on it, it will give me different options. It will ask me whether I want to go live, I want to post picture, you know, or I want to upload video. Once I tap, I want to, that is video I want to upload, to show me all the videos on my phone, and I can now select the video I want to upload. I think it's not open right now because of my Wi-Fi has gone off. You know, I'm in the sitting room and I plugged it in the master bedroom. Okay, so that's basically it. You upload your video from here, you can add your title, add everything, and you're good to go. So thank you very much. This is Whitey Bram once again. See you, Whitey Bram Tech. I'm a digital marketing expert, and this video is going to give you step-by-step guide how you can make money from YouTube and become a big boy of your own. Buy as many lamps you have as you like, invest, build your house, build your family, and never complain of lack of funds. Even inside recession, you'll be earning in dollars. If dollar is going up, you'll be happy, because by the time you convert it to naira, it's to your own favor. So guys, no dulling, 3 videos at least every day. Let's grind it. Thank you.